you know, to be careful, because you, once you get a sun cancer, you never go back, you die.
Unco Chinn. Hey, Unco Chinn goes to Abalone Cove part 2, this time with a friend. and of course, the best way to start Abalone Cove, with your Starbucks. And what's the best Starbucks? Cappuccino, extra dry, breve. Oh yeah, look. Unco summoned the marine layer, and the marine layer says yes. Layer all over that marine.
So one thing that's really important once you get to Abalone Cove is remember that you're parking at one end of the beach. Where most people park, it's like $6, but you're gonna walk to the opposite end. So kids, when you come to the Abalone Cove, you have to be careful of the lifeguard police not let you go around the corner to do the cliff jumping. You come with a friend, you have to sneak around the corner, yeah.
We're so live right now.
First live story ever.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Somebody probably just fell down the cliff like a dumbass. Yeah. But apparently, when you go out that way, you can go to the tide pool on the low tide. You can walk all the way out that way from the low tide. So cool. See?
So kids, when you come to the Abalone Cove, you make sure to take care of your skin. Okay, make sure you put all the sunblock on, and then you take care of your head, you know, to be careful, because once you get a sun cancer, you never go back, you die. You get pregnant and then you die. So don't get a sun cancer, okay? Also, the water's kind of nice, super cold. Unco don't like it. But then Unco noticed his nipple get very hot and crunchy, so it's okay. And then Unco get used to the water, it's okay. Okay, bye.
So, the lifeguard noticed that these guys are walking around the corner, ha ha ha. They're about to get fined. So bad. Oh no. The beach purple.
So, Unco find all the other hipster. They're so disappointed. No can go to the Abalone Cove. And they're so cool. They found it on YouTube or like a Facebook, but denied. You no can go. Unco can go. Unco can go. You no can go. That's right. Unco take you to the beach. Make you smell the fishy. Unco make you miss the beach. Looks like it's the Hawaii.
So, When you come to Abalone Cove, there's two ways in. One is from the parking lot on the north end. The problem is, you have to hike all the way across the beach to where all the people are. It's the opposite end, but that's the one where like Google Maps and stuff takes you to. So be prepared, it's a little hot. It's like $6 for parking, but when you walk up, there's like a trail slash road on the way back up. The problem is it doesn't take you back to the parking lot. So now you're stuck over here in the opposite end of the cove. So now you have to walk all the way back to literally over there. You take this road and you think, oh my god, it's so nice. Nope, because that is where you have to go back to. It's okay. So, Uncle No can decide what we want to eat, so we go to the Trader Joe Plaza nearby, and we notice there's like 5 restaurants, so we said, oh, we're gonna have 1 appetizer from each of them. Ha 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 ha. So as part of our mission to try all the, like get an appetizer from each place, we've decided that we're gonna get 1 small thing and try to not like drink, like eat or drink too much. It has to be 1 small thing, and then she can get a drink because, you know, she'd like the drink, so. Okay, so right now we are going to get the, what are we getting? I think we're going to get the satay chicken or beef. Or maybe like the lady finger or something like that. We'll get one of those, and then she also get a Thai gimlet. So guys, in case you don't know, many people who go to Thailand somehow think that it's okay to eat with a chopstick.
It's not frowned.
Thai people only eat chopstick when you're eating Japanese and Chinese food or Korean food. Because Thailand was influenced very strongly by the British.
Yes. No, it's a spoon.
Yeah? Maybe?
She creams.
Yeah.
That's good. It's good. We did good.
So guys, I have to say that while this is pretty good, it kind of has just like a, in my opinion, a kind of a bland taste. It's not bad. It's not bad at all, but like, I don't know. I feel like the taste is mostly just the wrapper and a little bit of the shrimp. Not bad.
I might say though, this place is pretty cool. Like, you get a look over at the ocean. It's nice and breezy, a lot of shade. And then you can go to Trader Joe's and get your weekly groceries after that. So why not, right? Okay, so that first one was, it was okay, but it was just kind of like, I don't know. It was funny because like the actual, yeah. It was not bad. Yeah. I know, for like, for 10 bucks, it was just like, that's like $2 a shrimp. That's pretty expensive. Ooh, hi. Okay, so now we are up to Osaka. Yeah, Osaka, Japanese cuisine. Hi-yo. Uncle go to the bathroom inside the Asahi place and look. Everything changed color. Everything changed color. It's so psychedelic. It makes the fish extra tasty.
Okay, we're doing tuna first? Mm-hmm. Oh my god, wait. Is that on film?
Mm-hmm. I'll cut it out.
I mean, I wanted to do this from the sushi. I have some sake. You didn't even wait for me, rude. This is how you hold sushi.
That's not how you hold sushi.
It's how you hold sushi, chopsticks. Mmm.
Mmm. Rice is rather vinegary. It's interesting.
Huh?
It's very interesting.
It's really good.
No. That's a very interesting taste. Okay. So, look.
Why did I take the blue one?
Look. No, do you want that one? Here.
No, I want this one. Get off.
Okay. You take the sushi. You turn it sideways. You grip it by here. You dip it into...
You just grab it. So
take one corner.
And you dip it.
Mm-hmm.
It's good?
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Oh my gosh.
Mmm. Mmm. That's good. The red snapper.
That's a red snapper.
Mmm.
My favorite.
Now I'm sold on red snapper.
You're welcome.
There you go.
You're welcome.
Yeah. Mmm.
It was really good.
Mmm.
Kind of another one, but we have so many other places to eat.
There you go. So Asahi, totally worth it. The snapper and the bluefin tuna, the snapper and the snatch, so good. The bathroom is like the most raved out bathroom possible.
I've never,
it's great.
I didn't see that part of
totally
it.
Come. All right, so the next place is called Admiral Risti, but I'm kind of worried this might be kind of expensive. Oh well. So after looking at the menu and getting a feel of the place,
don't park like that.
But I also feel like I want to be dressed up and maybe I don't know. Yeah, dressed up for this place. I'm not dressed up.
I don't want any oysters.
No, I love oysters.
No,
what are you talking
oysters.
About? I love oysters.
No, oysters.
Don't listen to her. I love oysters.
So the next place we hit was called Avenue Italy. Absolutely great place to have a fabulous dinner. What we only assumed was the owner was super, super nice to us. We explained, hey, we're only here for just a quick appetizer and we gotta go. He's like, please, come in. It was absolutely beautiful. Totally worth it. Would love to get dressed up and come back here for dinner sometime.
So the next one was a pokey place called Pokey Me. And not only was everything really nice and fresh, but there was also your choice of what you would like to put on for toppings. So this poke bowl looks really, really good. How much was it?
$11.
Not bad.
$11.
And as you can see right here, nice size. These are small.
That's a small.
That's a small.
This place just opened.
I low-key think they gave us the medium, but anyways, yeah, super nice, super awesome. It's nice, and they have the outdoor patio here as well, where we just decided to sit here.
Aggro table.
Mm-hmm. Table's a little aggro, but it's okay. Yeah. And if you can see there, we added furikake, grilled, like crunchy, spicy crab. But all the toppings you see on top, we added to ourselves. So good. And of course, I got sriracha because life can't be without a sriracha, baby. Okay, there we go. Tuna. Mmm. Nice, cold. Very fresh. Yeah?
Very fresh.
Mm-hmm. We got.
Fresh to death.
We got shoyu, some sesame oil, and a little bit of the ponzu sauce.
So much jalapeno.
Mmm, there's a lot of food.
Oh my gosh.
Wow. I think the progressive eating has made me feel almost full, but not quite full. So, yeah. And the one thing I like about poke is I feel like it's super duper healthy. Yeah.
I hear live music.
I know. Well, it sounds like live music. And what's nice is that this plaza has like free parking. So literally you have like five places here, five or six, plus a Trader Joe's, plus a little school for lucky kids. Literally overlooking the ocean, completely worth it. So unlike my drive last time, I don't know if I told you guys, when I actually drove here last week, couldn't go to Abalone Cove, kind of a total bust, went to Trader Joe's and got some grocery shopping, but yeah, it was good. But now, restaurant time, baby.
Because you know how to use chopsticks?
I mean, things just like fall off, you know?
Slippery fish.
Mm-hmm.
I think I missed the. I keep forgetting about the tuna.
No, you're eating the tuna.
That's I think I was getting the salmon.
Hmm? You mean spicy crab?
Spicy crab's good. I want a lot of it.
Mm-hmm. It turns out, guys, this is a soft opening, so completely worth it. Go check them out. Poke me. Poke me? Yeah.
Oh. There's one in Westwood, they say, too. The jalapenos aren't very spicy.
No, they're not. I've been finding that about most jalapenos though. Like even when I go for like pho, a lot of the jalapenos there, they're not spicy at all. Like my cross hand technique here.
They're not at all.
Mm-hmm. Right. Let's try the seeds.
What'd you eat?
The seeds. Not hot.
Oh.
Sometimes it feels like it's part of the breed because it's almost like eating.
Did you forget about your sriracha?
Oh my god, totally forgot about sriracha. It's fine. But see, that's how good it is. I forgot about sriracha.
I just like the crab.
Like the crab?
Is it real crab?
No.
Or imitation?
Imitation. 90% of the crab out there is imitation because it just costs way too much to make real crab.
Sometimes it's extremely spicy.
You probably got to dab the wasabi.
Woo-hoo.
Woo! Good morning, Vietnam.
Ooh. That was delicious.
Yeah. So, for two people, this is perfect as like a little kind of like main course slash appetizer-y kind of thing. The Italian place though was really good. I would totally like get dressed up. But they're super friendly and super nice. They knew that we were just going in for an appetizer and they were super nice about it too. So far, what do you think? Like, what do you think the best restaurant has been?
I liked my drink at the Thai place.
It was a good drink, but
the sushi was really good.
Mm-hmm.
I like all of it.
The bread threw me for a loop. The inside of the Italian place was super pretty, but the bread threw me for a loop because it was almost like a biscotti.
It looked like cornbread.
It was like cornbread because it had like a hard crust on both sides, but it was soft on the inside.
Like you.
I'm hard outside, but I'm soft inside.
like your emotions.
I'll take that.
Poke me.
Yes, please.
Pokey.
It's so funny. I met this really super cool guy, Mark, at Exchange yesterday. Mark, what's up?
Shout out.
Oh my God. Yes.
Shout out to my main man, Mark.
Mm-hmm.
Someone's coming.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like this angle. I kind of want a beer now.
Yeah, you want a beer?
Oh, Flaherty. Flaherty's.
We also didn't realize there is a pub behind us. Ooh, pub.
I thought you were showing me something.
It looks like an Irish pub.
Oh, Flaherty's. Flaherty's.
Oh, Flaherty's.
Flaherty's.
Oh, Flaherty's.
Oh, Flaherty's.
Oh, Flaherty's. Like,
oh my
I'm
God,
Flaherty.
That was a perfect bite. Ah. Yeah.
No.
Gotcha.
Do you like getting poke with rice or do you like getting poke with just greens?
Greens.
Yeah, right.
Rice is a waste of calories and it fills my stomach up so much. It makes me really uncomfortably full. Rice.
How much rice do you eat? I eat like...
whatever it comes with.
Really?
Well,
this is a very large serving though. I mean, honestly, this is larger than a lot
it
of places.
It looks bigger than the small.
Mm-hmm. It wasn't the small. He was being nice.
Was he?
That's what happens, guys, when you go out with like... a good looking person, they're like, oh, you're good looking. Have the big one.
Big one for two.
Mm-hmm.
Snag your spicy crab.
Yeah.
And I lost. Oh!
Oh, yeah?
No!
I win.
Now it's all smushed.
Ah! Okay, now that's mean. That's good. Go ahead.
I feel like everyone here is rich.
Yeah, it's Rancho Palos Verdes.
Rancho Cucamonga.
No, not even.
That's where the workaholics are from.
Yeah?
That's where it's shot. Or, well, they make it seem like it's shot there.
Really?
Rich kids.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Rich families. Rich families. Oh, they're all going to Oflaherty's.
Maybe we should too.
My stomach's really... if I had a beer, I'd be so full.
Okay.
Is it happy hour?
Yeah, it is.
On a Sunday?
Not on Sunday.
I'm gonna use the restroom. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
I was gonna hide and see if you saw.
I'm used to paparazzi.
Oh, excuse me.
I brought some water.
Yeah, where are you going? What are you doing? Oh my God, it's actually live music. Oh my gosh. We have to dance. We have to dance. Be like, play.
This is jazz.
Oh my God, this is great. So here's the question, is like, why would you be playing jazz music at a Mexican place? Maybe, well, you know what? No. Hell yeah, you can play jazz in a Mexican place. Duh. It's like someone's like, oh, you can't play this because it's not Mexican. Yeah. Definitely can play. I think it gets points. So this is tomatillo. Tomatillo Mexican Grill. Let's just say it's a little bit out of the ordinary. It's good.
Ooh, no.
Spicy.
Spicy. That must be the barbacoa.
Mhm. Well, okay. I did dip it in that too.
Ah.
The meat isn't really that spicy. It was just that sauce.
Loving the jazz.
Uh oh. We're going down.
Going down, down. Whoa. Spicy. Yeah. Ooh, I like
good.
It. I like this taste though.
It's my jam. I love that salsa. Mm. Sound like you snotted on it.
They were nice and gave us two sauces.
That wasn't that good. Again, we get what we want.
I also kind of question how if the owners are Polish or
they look Polish or maybe Russian.
Yeah. Hey, this is good.
Maybe they definitely do not speak.
Hmm?
They don't speak Mexican. Spanish.
You mean Spanish?
No.
Just come here.
So this is either the barbacoa or the carnita. I
think this is the carnitas. Looks like carnitas, yeah.
So, that one was hot. That one was a hot bite.
I feel like this place is Mexican inspired, but I'm loving the jazz. Loving the jazz. It gets major points for the jazz.
What is it?
Mm.
Is that the barbacoa?
It's barbacoa. Not this one. Ooh. Yeah, it's spicy. But it hits you at the end.
Ooh.
It hits you at the end. Yeah, right?
That's delicious. Are you sure?
Yeah, are you sure? Yeah, now see? Now you're sure. Because they said it isn't spicy.
But I thought carnitas was shredded like that. No, that is it.
See?
That's my favorite, probably.
It's very subtle. I like the subtlety at the end. I like the subtlety because at first you're like, this is okay. You're like, oh. Yeah, right?
Good.
Yeah.
See, I feel like I'm getting my second one now.
Yeah, right?
It's because this was just a completely different flavor than everything that we've been eating.
Yeah.
Ooh, hot.
All right. So I feel like the overall, hitting all five, except five out of the six restaurants here, excellent. Most of them been pretty good, actually pretty good. It's hot. Oh yeah.
I feel like the Thai place we really didn't give a fair chance.
Yeah, Thai place didn't quite get a fair chance.
But we should have got the papaya salad.
I also think that it's a shame to let all this hot sauce go to waste.
Cheers.
Hot sauce shots. Because the internet wants to see this shit.
Tomatoes.
It's probably like the roasted stuff. Yeah, it has a lot of tomato in it.
Ugh.
It's like the roasted.
What are you gonna do with all this?
No, I don't do sour cream. But, yeah. So, what was your favorite so far? Out of all of them?
Probably this, actually.
This one? Really? Yeah. What would you, if you were to come here and eat something on the regular, where would you go?
The seafood place that we skipped. But I'd come with like a black American Express card. Out of the ones that we ate, it depends on what we were in the mood for because we literally ate every type of meat.
What do you think is the most value for the dollar? I really like the jazz.
This place
is winning like for the music. This is $8 for three tacos, which is a little more than normal, like sweet taco flavor, but you get jazz and it's pretty cool. So yeah, for free cheese.
Tap water.
Every place had free tap water. Best free tap water so far was the Poke Place.
Wait.
Poke Place had excellent tap water.
Oh, see, I was thinking it was the like Italian mint place because it came in a glass bottle. But yeah, no.
Okay.
Are you sweating? Are you crying? Are you crying from the hot sauce you just chucked?
No, barely.
This is not even close to sweating.
Well, guys, that's it. That's 5 restaurants in 3 hours. And yeah.
So we're trying to look for Hidden Mickey, and it's somewhere around here, but we just found it. It seems easy, but it's not really. If you look somewhere at those cones, point it to the cones.
Well, is it a Mickey or? It's actually a hidden Buzz.